What you doing?
To watch TV.
Hey guys, I'm Leland and welcome back to Short Notice. With me right now, I have the director and actor of our next film, Being Real, Patricio Janelza and Philip Jean-Marie. Guys, thank you so much for being here.
Pleasure being here.
Thank you.
Yay. So this next film, Being Real, was a spontaneous project. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
Yeah, it was actually part of a 72-hour competition which took place at the 2008 LA Film Festival, sponsored by Canon. I was chosen to compete in it on a Wednesday night. Took 3 days to write it, shoot it, edit it. It was due Saturday, I believe, and then it premiered the following Tuesday, and it won.
Wow.
I won a camera out of it.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, so I was the top dog that night.
What kind of camera did you win?
Canon HF10, which has now become obsolete.
Oh, yeah.
But no, it was a great camera. I actually shot a music video with one of my favorite artists. I ended up winning an award, another award.
So this award begat another award.
And I'm a director because I love Sunday cones.
So for Being Real, you wrote, produced, edited, directed everything for this film. Which one of those hats do you prefer to wear, or is it all of them?
I guess I'm used to wearing all kinds of hats on set, mm-hmm. only because when I was 12 years old, when I started making movies as a kid, that's what I did, you know? So it felt like I just had to kind of tap into that kid in me. I mean, 3 days, I had never done that before, making a movie within that short amount of time. But this competition really forced me to kind of like get with it. You know, it's almost like someone putting a gun to your head and saying, right, you have only 72 hours to create a movie. Being able to kind of tap into all the different kind of hats, I think that's the reason why I was very successful during that competition.
Are you grateful for the experience after everything?
If I had to think about in the last 5 years, what was that moment that got me to, you know, motivated to get that fire burning, to continue filmmaking, it was that moment when I won.
If she's there and it was meant to be, then I know that she's the one for me.
Now, Philip, do you consider yourself more of the realist in the film or the dreamer, the character that you play?
Definitely the dreamer. Being an actor, you kind of have to have a sense of optimism, you know, and just belief that, like, you are gonna succeed. You know, you wanna do what you love to do, you know, because this is what fulfills me, you know, which is acting. You know, I get paid to play make-believe. It's amazing, it's fun.
This was our first collaboration together, and I've actually known Philip through, we have mutual friends, and to be honest, he was always known as, oh, he's the Power Ranger, you know?
Because you were the Power Ranger.
I was a Power Ranger, I was a Blue Power Ranger.
The Power Ranger.
Not the Power Ranger.
on set, though, we really got to talk about, like, during our downtime and during that crazy shoot, and I always tend to reuse the same cast members over, just because it's almost like a family thing, community. We always like to support each other. Mm-hmm. And honestly, Philip is really,
you guys,
really
are your
talented
own,
actor. Yeah.
Judd Apatow crew.
And they all get along, so I never want friction on my set. So, you know.
So Patricio, tell me about Kid Heroes, your production company.
I think the one thing that we try to specialize in is community filmmaking. So usually when we have any project, I'll hire my core professionals, but I'll also pad it up with volunteers and people who are probably aspiring filmmakers or film students, and then we'll pad it with community people who have no film experience whatsoever but are just down to help. Kid Heroes really was named after the movies I shot as a kid.
So it's a very symbolic name.
Very sentimental, you know.
Philip, I gotta ask, how was it being the Blue Power Ranger? That's so cool.
Oh, it was one of the best experiences of my life. To see, like, little kids look at you in awe. Like, I remember being in Vegas, and then I was in this convenience store, and this little kid was, like, whispering to his mom and staring at me. And I just caught him in the corner of my eye. I was like, what's going on? What are you doing? And then finally, his mom came over to me and asked, well, are you the Blue Power Ranger? And I was like, ah, yes, I am. That's me.
So. Thank you so much again for taking the time to be here on the show and share your experiences. So cool talking to both of you.
Cool.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.